The story that you are about to hear is a compilation of documented true facts, featuring characters, events, or places that has played a role in shaping history. Please sit back and listen as I recite this narrative for you. Bela Kiss was a Hungarian serial killer. He is thought to have murdered at least 24 young women and one man, and attempted to pickle their bodies in large metal drums that he kept on his property. Kiss was born on July 28, 1877, and was thought to have an incestuous relationship with his mother, Verona Varga. He was a thin smith who had lived in Sinkota, nowadays part of Budapest, Hungary, since 1900. His neighbors considered him a pleasant man to live with. Kiss was an amateur astrologer and allegedly fond of other occult practices. He was married twice and had two children, Aranka and Ilonka. In 1912, Kiss hired a housekeeper and began to correspond with a number of attractive women and sometimes took them to his home in Sinkota. Typically through advertisements, he would place in newspapers offering his services as either a matrimonial agent or a fortune teller. However, his housekeeper, Mrs. Jakubek, never really got to know any of them. Townsfolk also noticed that Kiss had collected a number of metal drums. Kiss had told the town police who questioned him that he filled them with gasoline in order to prepare for the rationing of the oncoming war. When World War I began, he was conscripted and left his house in the care of Mrs. Jakubek. In July 1916, Budapest police received a call from a Sinkota landlord who had found seven large metal drums. The landlord explained that a soldier named Bela Kiss had rented the house he owned on Kossoth Street, but had let the lease lapse and was rumored to be a prisoner of war or possibly even killed in battle. The landlord had gone to the house to see what repairs were needed before he put the house up for rent again. Outside the house, he found several large metal drums. When he punctured one of the drums, a nauseating smell overwhelmed him. The chemist next door told him that it was the unmistakable smell of human decomposition. The landlord begged Detective Chief Charles Nagy to urgently investigate. He could not rent out the house again until this matter was resolved. Against the protests of Mrs. Jakubek, they opened one of the drums. Submerged in a brine of methanol was the relatively well-preserved body of a young woman with long brown hair, along with the rope that had strangled her. The six other drums bore the same grisly contents, naked or partially clothed corpses of young women and the same murder weapon, a length of rope. The methanol, also known as wood alcohol, acted as a preservative, keeping decomposition to a minimum. Each opened lid revealed another young corpse until somewhere between 24 and 30 were logged into the police file. All the victims had been strangled. Some reportedly had dual puncture marks on their neck, as though Kiss had drained them of their blood. It's not clear whether he did so, but theorizing around the wounds has led some to dub Bela Kiss the Vampire of Sinkota. Nagy informed the police that they should arrest Bela Kiss immediately if he was still alive. There was also a possibility that he was a prisoner of war. The name, unfortunately, was very common. Kiss means little in Hungarian. Nagy also arrested the housekeeper Jakubek and asked the postal service to hold any possible letters to Kiss in case he had an accomplice that could warn him. Nagy initially suspected that Jakubek might have had something to do with the murders, especially when Kiss had left her money in his will. Jakubek assured police that she knew absolutely nothing about the murders. She showed them a secret room Kiss had told her never to enter. The room was filled with bookcases, but also had a desk that held a number of letters, Kiss's correspondence with 74 women and a photo album. Many of the books were about poisons or strangulations. From the letters, Nagy discerned several things. The oldest of the letters were from 1903, and it became clear that Kiss was defrauding the women, especially middle-aged, who had been looking for marriage. He had placed ads in the marriage columns of several newspapers and had selected mainly women who had no relatives living nearby and knew no one who would quickly notice their disappearance. He wooed them and convinced them to send him money. If they proved troublesome for him, he killed them. One woman, Catherine Varga, sold her profitable dressmaking business and was last seen leaving her house in Budapest to join Kiss in Sinkota. One woman, whose name was found stitched into clothing in Kiss's house, was later identified as Julianne Pashak. Her name appeared in court records in Budapest. She had sued Kiss for defrauding her of money on the promise of marriage. Her case was thrown out when she failed to show up to the hearing. On October 4, 1916, Nagy received a letter that stated that Kiss was recuperating in a Serbian hospital. Nagy arrived too late. Kiss had fled and substituted a dead body of another soldier in his bed. Nagy alerted all of the Hungarian police. Unfortunately, all the sightings police could check proved to be wrong. The hospital encounter would be the closest anyone would come to catching Hungary's Lonely Heart Slayer, although over the decades, several people would claim to spot him, especially as news of his crime spread throughout the world. On several later occasions, speculation arose that Bela Kiss had perhaps faked his death by exchanging identities with a dead soldier during the war. He was supposedly sighted numerous times in the following years, and there were various rumors about his fate, including that he had been imprisoned for burglary in Romania or he had died of yellow fever in Turkey. Several facts made the investigation even harder than normal. Thousands of Hungarian soldiers were imprisoned, and the army was scattered and disorganized. Worse, the names Bela and Kiss were extremely common Hungarian names. It was likely that there were many, many men in the army named Bela Kiss. In 1920, a soldier in the French Foreign Legion reported on another legionnaire named Huffman. The name Kiss had used in some letters, who had boasted how good he was at using a garrote, and who fits Kiss's description. Huffman deserted before police could reach him. In 1932, homicide detective Henry Oswald was certain he had seen Kiss coming out of Times Square subway in New York City. There were also rumors that Kiss was living in the city and working as a janitor, but they could not be verified. In 1936, a rumor spread that Kiss was working as a janitor in some apartment buildings on 6th Avenue. Again, he managed to evade police, and there the trail grew cold. Whatever finally became of Bela Kiss, if he was ever in New York at all, remains a mystery beyond solution with the passage of a full half century. In Hungary, he is remembered as the one who got away. The fate of Bela Kiss remains unknown to this day. Hey everyone! I just wanted to express how grateful I am that you took the time to listen to my narration. Hopefully you enjoyed it. I am Twisted Mind, and please enjoy the rest of your day. Salamat!